Hare Krishna. So before I begin, I seek the prayers and the blessings of all superior Vaishnavas sitting here, all Prabhujis and Matajis who are sitting here. Please kindly pray to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and to Srila Prabhupada that may the right words come from my mouth in the right time, in the right spirit, glorifying the wonderful pastime of Gajendra. I am not qualified as far as age, experience, realization, knowledge, or any practical realization of bhakti is concerned. But please bless me so that by your prayers, may Krishna as Paramatma speak through my words. It is a tradition that before we start hearing from Srimad-Bhāgavatam, we glorify Srimad-Bhāgavatam. Because Srimad-Bhāgavatam is not a book. Srimad-Bhāgavatam is a person. Srimad-Bhāgavatam is Sakshat Bhagavan Shri Krishna. Sometimes we feel that, oh, this is paper and ink. White paper and black ink. So this is book. But Srimad-Bhāgavatam is Vāṅmay Swarup, is the literature incarnation of Krishna. Shri Krishna can manifest in any form. When he manifests as rock, it is Giriraj. When he manifests as water, in different contexts, different holy rivers are referred to. Ganga, Yamuna, and ultimately Sri Radhakund. When Krishna appears as our living guidance, it is Sri Guru. When Krishna agrees to appear as sound, it is the holy name. When Krishna appears in the form of land, it is Sridham Vrindavan. And similarly, when Krishna agrees to appear in the form of book, the books are Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. So let us offer our prayers to this personality, Sri Krishna, who is manifesting in his book incarnation. Let us pray to him that let, by the mercy of our parampara, may the realizations of the Bhagavatam enter our discussion. So let us offer a prayer. Please repeat. परमानंद पाठाय प्रेम वर्षी अक्षरायते सर्वदा सर्वसेव्याय श्री कृष्णाय नमोस्तु मे. परमानंद पाठाय श्रीमद् भागवतम इज रेडी टू फिल अस विथ सुप्रीम ब्लिस. For those who read and study Srimad Bhagavatam, pathan, adhyayan, those who study Srimad Bhagavatam as their life, for them, for those readers, Srimad Bhagavatam provides paramananda. There is jad ananda. There is happiness of the flesh, which we all aspire for. That is why we are in this body. So we are all looking for pleasure of the skin. That is jad. That is temporary, that is flickering, it has an end. But Srimad Bhagavatam gives Parama Ananda Pathaya. For those who read Srimad Bhagavatam as a student in proper parampara and hear it from the lips of great personalities like Srila Prabhupada and his followers, for them their lives are filled with happiness. And Prema Varshi Aksharayate. Through the syllables of the Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a shower of pure love for Krishna. Some scriptures give dharma, artha, kama, and some even go ahead to give moksha. But Srimad Bhagavatam gives prema, the ultimate sadhya, the ultimate goal for all of us. Simply getting liberated from material existence doesn't solve our problem. Our problem is forgetfulness of Krishna. We at the present moment don't have rati or asakti or love for Krishna. So when we get filled with bhava or prema, pure love for Krishna, that solves the problem. So Srimad Bhagavatam through the aksharas, through the syllables of Srimad Bhagavatam, fill our life with shower of prema. Therefore, sarvada, sarva sevyaya. Da refers to time. Yada, tada, sarvada, ekada, So sarvada means always, sarva means all of us, sevyaya. Srimad Bhagavatam should be served by all of us at all times to come. By worshipping Srimad Bhagavatam, by reading Srimad Bhagavatam, by studying Srimad Bhagavatam, by speaking Srimad Bhagavatam, by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, and by discussing Srimad Bhagavatam. Why is it so important? The last line says, Shri Krishnaya Namostume. O Srimad Bhagavatam, I am glorifying and worshipping you because you are Sakshat Bhagavan Shri Krishna. So, Paramananda Pathaya Prema Varshaksharayate. Your syllables are filled with love and therefore you fill us with love and happiness. Sarvada Sarva Sevyaya Shri Krishnaya Namostume. Therefore, to that Shri Krishna Bhagavan who appears in the form of the literature, we bow down and we serve all the time. So with this verse, understanding the glory of Srimad Bhagavatam, we pray to Srimad Bhagavatam and we begin. Now this literature, Srimad Bhagavatam, talks about different pastimes. And interestingly, the Srimad Bhagavatam goes from one chapter to another, to another, to another in the form of conversations, discussions. Whenever there is a discussion between two people, it is very exciting. Yes? If you're seeing a play, a drama, and only one person is speaking, he's standing in front of you and speaking. After some time, it gets boring. But if there are two people talking, and the third person comes into the picture, and the fourth person comes, and there is discussion between everyone, everybody is attentive. Nobody sleeps. So our Shukdev Goswami is such a genius that he scripts this whole Srimad Bhagavatam, and it goes in one conversation after another, after another, after another. Similarly, Krishna also in the Bhagavad Gita gives this whole nectar of Gita, Gitamritam, in the form of questions and answers. Out of the different stories which are described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, this section that we are discussing today is glorious. For so many ages, by so many sages, by so many devotees, in so many places, this pastime has been sung. Practically in this assembly, there is nobody who has not heard of Gajendra. Right from the time we are children, we are born in this world, one of the first stories we are taught is the story of Gajendra. In fact, in my personal experience, the first story from the Bhagavatam that I heard as a child was Gajendra Moksha. And in our own typical baby talk, we would talk about Gajendra, 2 minutes, the whole story is over. How the crocodile caught, and how the elephant cried, and how the Supreme Lord came, and Gajendra is saved. So this story, all of us know, it's very entertaining. But what are the principal lessons, what are the details out of this pastime, which make our life meaningful, is very important. That is why we are all discussing this. So the pastime of Gajendra, in the first 3 chapters of the 8th canto, it's a long discussion, of course, but in this section of the discussion, verse 31, we find till now the mention of the great king, the king of elephants, and not normal elephants, heavenly elephants, Gajendra described. Gajendra lived in a region called as the Trikuta, one of the heavenly abodes, and was very, very powerful. Now we know how powerful an elephant can be. If an elephant uses his trunk, there is destruction. If the elephant uses his feet, there is destruction. In fact, there is destruction even when the elephant uses his tail. So a worldly elephant of this world can cause so much havoc, so many destructions. There are so many videos we find elephants just climbing on the car and the car is finished. Mad elephant gets into a jungle and everything is uprooted. So one elephant can be so destructive. What to speak of heavenly elephant? And now what to speak of the king of heavenly elephants? Very respectable position. Very strong. Gajendra was effulgent. And very influential. People respected Gajendra. Whenever and wherever Gajendra walked, all the animals bowed down. They all bowed down. In fact, those who didn't like Gajendra, they also bowed down out of fear. Arey, if I don't bow down to him, he'll kill me. So better I bow down. So there was respect, there was honor, there was name, fame, there was strength, there was position, everything that you can aspire for, Gajendra had it. And more importantly, he had a very wonderful family with many wives, not just one wife, and not just one child. Many children out of many wives, big family, lot of fan following, lot of friends, lot of well-wishers. People always glorified Gajendra. So Gajendra had everything that you and I in this world, in the material sense, would aspire for. All of us aspire for wealth. When we get little fame, we think we have become Indra. We want honor, recognition. We like to be strong. We like to be appreciated. We like to be intelligent. And we like to be effulgent and influential. And Gajendra had it all. And as most of the rich and aristocratic people would decide, Gajendra decided to go for a vacation. His family said, it's long time, we have not taken a break. Let's go for a vacation. So Gajendra, with all his friends, his wives, his children, his well-wishers, they all went to a very wonderful, serene atmosphere. Very peaceful. Birds are chirping. Bees are humming. And then Gajendra looked to his wives and hinted towards a very beautiful pond filled with lotus flowers. So it was considered to be a very romantic and very serene atmosphere. Gajendra felt, this is what I want. Break, chutti. Break from whatever I am. He entered. And to play with his own men, he was splashing water. With his trunk, he picked up water, was splashing on them. They were enjoying. Gajendra was enjoying. And at that moment of utter enjoyment, in an unexpected manner, came a crocodile. A crocodile came out of nowhere when Gajendra was so happy and blissful. And in 1 minute, Gajendra was enjoying at this level, and immediately the jaws, the strong, sharp teeth of a crocodile caught the feet of Gajendra. Now for us, in this world, if we have a paper cut, we have a problem. Arey, dukh raha hai. Galti se chaku, while cutting fruits and vegetables, galti se chaku lag jaye, to hum log bhaktoon ko bolte hain, Allah wala machate ki, haath kat gaya, ungli kat gayi. But here is Gajendra, whose feet was caught by the jaws of a crocodile. And Gajendra had two kinds of pain. One was the physical pain and the other was the emotional pain. Now externally he was very strong. Elephant, very strong. But inside, they're still sensitive, soft. So the crocodile's jaws and teeth just penetrated, sunk through the flesh of Gajendra. He started biting and chewing. Mahaprasade Govinde. Shri Shri Radha Rasbihari Bhagavan ki jai. Shri Shri Gaurnitai Bhagavan ki jai. Shri Shri Radha Shri Shri Sitaram Lakshman Hanuman Bhagavan ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. The crocodile started chewing. Blood started oozing. Gajendra was in excruciating pain, physical pain. And now what was the emotional pain? The emotional pain was the fact that such a big person, not elephant, heavenly elephant, that took king of heavenly elephants, who protects everyone, is now begging to his own men for his protection. This is dishonor. To be insulted in public amongst people who glorify you is big dishonor. Yes? If there are 100 people who love you and glorify you, and one person comes out of nowhere and in public starts criticizing, big dishonor. And just like Bali Maharaj could not stand false, he was so attached to truth, couldn't stand falsity. For him, falsity was worse than death. And just like Draupadi, for whom disrobing was worse than death, because for her chastity was most important. So just like Bali Maharaj valued truth, just like Draupadi valued chastity, Gajendra valued honor. For Bali, falsity was worse than death. For Draupadi, being disrobed in public in front of superiors, in front of her own men, is worse than death. Similarly, for Gajendra, to be in such a pathetic condition, crying out to his own men whom he protects, "Are Baba, please save me, protect me. I am begging you for my protection." This dishonor was worse than death. He was shattered. And if we carefully analyze, the pastime of Draupadi and the pastime of Gajendra run in parallel. Draupadi had everything, Gajendra had everything. Draupadi was very powerful, although she was a lady. Krishna, very powerful. Gajendra was very powerful. In less than a minute, in public, Draupadi was being disrobed. In less than a minute, in public, Gajendra was being dishonored. And initially, both of them cried for their protection. Draupadi was crying around, "Please protect me." She looked to her husbands, she looked to her superiors, she looked everywhere for help, but nobody could help. Similarly, Gajendra was in a pathetic condition where he was asking his own children, "Please protect me." What can be worse? But the interesting point is, both of them tried, and the parallel is both of them failed. Draupadi tried protecting herself, but she failed. Gajendra tried protecting himself, but he failed. So the first lesson out of the story of Gajendra that we can learn as sadhakas is the fact that all of us are struggling with crocodiles in our life. All of us are Gajendras in some bit or the other. It's not that this story is somewhere and I am somewhere. We are connected. Gajendra was king. We also think we are kings in some place or the other. And this crocodile who caught Gajendra and caused so much havoc in our life is the crocodile of material nature. We think we are very happy, but every second we are getting closer to death. So you've seen a crocodile, how the crocodile eats, puts its mouth, person is 10% inside. Then after some time, another chew, 25% inside. Another chew, 45% inside. And in no time, the percent is 100% in. Similarly, in our life, the crocodile of time factor, the crocodile of death is chewing us. Every sunrise and sunset, we are one day inside the mouth of the crocodile. The pond is the material world. So just like Gajendra decided to go and enjoy in the pond, we by our own swaichha are in this material world trying to enjoy vacation. And the crocodile of death, the crocodile of suffering, the crocodile of maya, the crocodile of time factor, the crocodile of material nature is chewing us 1 minute after another, after another, after another, after another. But do you know what the sad part is? The sad part is Gajendra realized that he's being chewed, but we are bleeding, but we are not realizing. Instead, when somebody asks us, "How are we?" we say, "I'm fine, thank you." And we ask the other person, he also says, "I'm fine, thank you." But every day, every month, every year, every birthday, we are 1 year inside the mouth of the crocodile. And we are all suffering. There is suffering everywhere in this material world. Wherever we go, there is suffering. One devotee in the congregation, he was part of the devotee community in Mumbai. And he used to travel a lot to come to the temple. And we know how the local trains in Mumbai are. Very interesting, fascinating. When people enter the local train, it is as if there is a Kohinoor gem inside. They're all jumping. And when the station comes, they're all jumping as if there is a cobra inside, snake, ready to chew. So everybody is jumping out. So this person was frustrated with life in Mumbai. He said, I'm going to London. Comfortable life. So he went to London. 8:30 after office, he sat into an empty bus. In Mumbai, you cannot imagine this. After office, 8:30 at night, getting into an empty bus means only one thing, you are dreaming. Or you are in some other city, not in Mumbai. So after work, 8:30, he got into the bus, empty. He's sitting and the driver is sitting. Blissful. He was thinking, I'm in Vaikuntha. So as he was seeing and enjoying this, he saw a CCTV camera there. So he asked the driver, why you have CCTV camera? So the driver said, you know, see, the buses go vacant. Nobody enters the bus. So sometimes some thieves enter. Daku, goon, rogues, they enter. And they get their gun, they get their knife. They steal, pickpocket, and sometimes kill also. So just so that we know who has killed, the CCTV camera is there. So this person was afraid. So the driver said, don't worry. Even if something happens to you, your family will get justice. Don't worry. I mean, in India, if you put CCTV camera first, they will take the CCTV camera out, public. So seeing all this, he told the driver, I came to London escaping Mumbai to not have problems. But after coming here, there is more problem. I think I was better in Mumbai. In Mumbai, there is so much crowd that nobody will come and kill. At least pocket is lost, but nobody will kill. So in this way, whether it is Mumbai, whether it is Shanghai, whether it is Los Angeles, or whether it is London, wherever we go, problems will continue. The crocodile will not leave us. Sometimes being in India, we think, America jana chahiye. People in America are thinking, India jana chahiye. So this struggle is there. We think by changing places, we will be happy. But however we change our circumstance, if our consciousness doesn't change, the crocodile will not leave us. Crocodile is following constantly. So problems are there everywhere. Janma, Mrityu, Jara, Vyadhi doesn't leave us anywhere. One person is a big engineer, but he used to run a coffin business. You know coffin? Dafnane ke liye lagate hain. Kya bolte hain Hindi mein usko? Coffin ko kya kehte hain? Dafnane ke liye jo deh ko lagate hain niche. Tabut. Coffin. So coffin, he used to have coffin business. So somebody went and asked him, "Are you an engineer, software engineer, you will be working in big companies. Why you are running this coffin business? If you want to do business, you can do other business. Why coffin business?" He said, coffin business is hit because here market never goes low. Continuously somebody or the other is dying. So death or the crocodile of suffering and pain continues wherever. And Srila Prabhupada would time and again hammer this point. One time Srila Prabhupada was in Miami. This was the first time Prabhupada was coming to a place called Miami in Florida. In the US. So Prabhupada asked, what is the name of the place? So the disciple said, Miami. Prabhupada said, interesting name, Maya and me. Fascinating combination, Maya and me. And after that, Prabhupada gave a class on whether you are in Mumbai or whether you are in Miami. Maya doesn't leave you. The crocodile of Maya is always there. So the story of Gajendra is not simply a story that we read in the Srimad-Bhāgavatam and we forget. It is something that we all can relate to. Very, very relevant story. At another instance, Srila Prabhupada was on a morning walk. Ocean beach. Big place. ocean shore. And the disciple who was walking with Śrīla Prabhupāda said, Prabhupāda, look at the ocean. It is so beautiful, isn't it? Śrīla Prabhupāda said, yes, very beautiful, but at a distance. If you go very close, the ocean will take you inside. So they said, yes, but what is the lesson? Prabhupāda said, the lesson is, Maya is like this. She looks very attractive from a distance, but as soon as you go close, she will take inside. One of our devotees went for Jagannath Puri Yatra. And when he went for Yatra, the ocean bath, they had snan. So they made announcement. Those who don't know to swim, please don't go beyond this line. And this person was expert swimmer. So he said, I can go anywhere. And he went beyond the line and he went to the other side. And after some time, he started drowning. And nobody realized. He was asking for help. He was doing like this. And all the devotees saw and they thought, oh, he's happy. He's saying Hari Bol. They also started saying Hari Bol. After some time, he's again doing Hari Bol. They're also saying Hari Bol. Then one brahmachari said, Are, I think he's doing too much Hari Bol. There is something wrong. So the rescue operator dived inside and he went and he saved him, came out. And he asked him, Are, why did you go there? The person said, I am an expert swimmer, so I thought nothing will happen to me. But I was drowning. And when he went and told his spiritual master, he said, this is overconfidence. Srila Prabhupada always said, the biggest problem with the devotees of ISKCON is that they don't fear Maya enough. We think, oh, I am chanting, Maya will not touch me. But if we are vigilant, careful, alert, that come what may, I am inside the jaws of the crocodile. The crocodile is not going to leave me. And just like Gajendra called out, I have to call out. If I don't call out, I will not be relieved. The crocodile will not leave me. The crocodile will keep chewing more and more and more and more. But our mind will tell us, Gajendra was in pain. I am not in pain. I am happy. But we have to tell ourselves the teeth, the jaws of Maya are such that some teeth of Maya, when they bite, it is very pleasurable. When Maya, through her teeth of wealth, gives us too much wealth, pleasurable. When Maya, through one of the teeth, gives too much respect and honor and recognition, pleasurable. When Maya gives position in society, pleasurable. But we must understand, this pleasure is not pleasure for the soul. That is also one of the sharp teeth of the jaws of the crocodile of Maya. So therefore, the only way to be free from the crocodile bite is what? Call out to a person who is stronger than the crocodile. His Holiness Sachinandan Swami Maharaj, in one class, he was saying how when he was a child, he had a friend who had a very ferocious dog. So Srila Sachinandan Maharaj would go to meet his friend as a boy, young boy. And every time he would go, the dog would chase him and would bark and almost come to bite. And Maharaj would palpitate, very afraid, and somehow reach the house of the boy. But one day he realized, till when is this dog gonna chase me? This dog thinks I'm an outsider. Till when is this dog gonna chase me? So one day he decided, when the dog starts chasing me, I'm going to call to my friend, who's the master of the dog. So when the dog started chasing, Maharaj called out to his friend and said, Are, tell your dog to be quiet. This dog is chasing me. And as soon as Maharaj's friend came out and told the dog, Are, be quiet, he's my friend. Don't shout, don't bark, don't bite. The dog became peaceful. So when Maharaj was saying this, I was thinking, what is the relevance? Because the verse that Maharaj was speaking on was, Daivi hyesha gunamai mama maya duratyaya mameva ye prapadhyante mayam etam tarantite. Krishna says, Daivi hyesha gunamai mama maya duratyaya, that this material nature, problems of this world, three modes of material nature and death, they are very cruel. And only those who surrender to Krishna, mam eva ye prapadhyante. Prapadhyante doesn't mean just approach. Prapadhyante doesn't just mean giving dandavat every day. Prapadhyante means taking our heart and keeping at Krishna's feet. Shraddha means to keep our heart. When we keep our heart on this, we have deep shraddha on our phone. When we keep our heart to the relations of this world, we have deep shraddha, faith, attachment. But that day when we keep our heart at the lotus feet of Krishna, end of material existence. So Maharaj, to explain that point, he said, why should we take shelter of Krishna? Because two things. Krishna is stronger than Maya. And second, Krishna is the master of Maya. So he said, similarly, my friend was stronger than the dog and was the master of the dog. And as soon as I approached him and he quietened the dog, from that day onwards, the dog didn't trouble me. So similarly, in this example, Krishna is like our friend. And Maya or material nature is like that barking, biting dog, or in this case, the crocodile. Till the time we don't approach Krishna, Hari, Sakshat Bhagavan, Brajendra Nandana Shamasundar, Bhagavan Shri Krishna, this crocodile bite, the strong jaws will never leave us. So therefore, we must, the first lesson in our life from the story of Gajendra is that we are all Gajendras in some way or the other. And we are in the pond of this material world, trying to enjoy with our family, friends, wives, children. And the crocodile of material nature, the crocodile of time, the crocodile of death, the crocodile of janma mrityu jara vyadhi, the crocodile of adidaivik, adibhautik, adhyatmik klesha, the crocodile of everything that exists is biting us. And part B of the same point is that we will be relieved only and only when we approach Krishna like Gajendra did. How he approached, we'll come to the second aspect. But in the first aspect, he approached. But how did he approach? What was his mood? Did Gajendra call out to the Lord as, oh Lord, if you are there, please come. If you are seeing, and if you have the mood, please come. See, I am just calling out to you. I am not in pain. I don't need you. But if you want to come, you come. Did he call out like that? He was calling out with thought, word and deed. Vak, vapu. Through actions, through his trunk, he uprooted a lotus and he was offering, which means seva. Through his senses, he was offering service. What can an elephant do? And the same parallel we find in Draupadi also. She offered her hand in service. Draupadi offered her hand and Gajendra offered the equivalent of his hand, his trunk. And he offered the lotus. Draupadi offered her voice. Hey Krishna, hey Govinda. Hey Krishna, hey Govinda. Hey Krishna, hey Govinda. Draupadi called out. And similarly, Gajendra used his tongue, vak, to glorify and give stuti. And at the same time, through mind, how were Draupadi and Gajendra calling out? Was Draupadi in the mood that Krishna, if you want to help, you may help. In fact, I don't even know whether you exist. Was this the mood? When we touch our heart and ask ourselves how our chanting is, sometimes we doubt everything practically. Am I actually spirit soul? What if I'm body? What if I'm enjoying? And at the end I realize, Arey Baba, I was not spirit soul. I missed the opportunity of enjoying this material world. We doubt everything. We doubt whether I'm spirit soul. We doubt whether God exists. If God exists, does he have a form? If he has a form, is it Krishna? And if it is Krishna, is he seeing me? If he's seeing me, is he hearing my prayers? We doubt everything practically. But Gajendra and Draupadi called out to the Lord as their life and soul. They were convinced that Krishna exists, Krishna is seeing me, Krishna is listening to me, and more importantly, Krishna is here. Krishna is not anywhere else. He's here with me, for me. So when our prayers to Krishna, our chanting, our reading of Srimad Bhagavatam, our seva becomes so intense, helpless, desperate, with so much faith, conviction, and hopelessness, Krishna, without you, I have nobody. That is when the Supreme Lord comes and the crocodile jaws are opened. One Vaishnav, Sri Vaishnav Acharya, in the Padyavali, he writes, Kshauni patitvam athavaika makinchanatvam nityam dadasi bahumanam athapamanam vaikunthavasam atava narake nivasam ha vasudeva mama nasti gatistvad anya. He says, O Krishna, O Supreme Lord, Kshauni patitvam, make me the king, athava eka akinchanatvam, or make me a beggar, no problem. Nityam dadasi bahumanam, create my life in such a way that I get a lot of respect. Athava apamanam, or create my life in such a way that I get only dishonor. So first line, make me king or beggar. Second line, give me lot of respect or give me lot of criticism. Third line, Vaikuntha vasam athava narake nivasam. My Lord, give me residence in Vaikuntha or throw me into hell. But fourth line is important. Ha vasudeva mama na asti gati tvat anya. O Supreme Lord, without you, I have nobody else. When we think my money will save me, my children will save me, my family will save me, my insurance, life insurance will save me, my medical insurance will save me, the doctors will save me. Arre, doctors don't save anybody. Vaidya Raja Namastubhyam Yamaraj Sahodaram Yama Tu Harati Pranan Tutva Pranan Dhanani Cha. O doctors of this world, I bow down to you. You are the brother of Yamaraj. Yama Tu Harati Pranan. Yamaraj takes away life. Tutva Pranan Dhanani Cha. You take life also and money also. So we have this faith that doctors of this world, our money, our family, our country, whatever I am earning will protect me. But alas, 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 we spend 70 years of our life collecting that wealth which doesn't help us. And that prema dhana, bhakti dhana, which actually helps us, we alas, we have no time to collect. So this Acharya is saying, Ha Vasudeva mama nasti gatistvadanya, O Krishna, apart from you, other than you, I have no other shelter, Krishna. So if you want to make me a beggar, you make me a beggar. You want to make me a king, you make me a king. You give me lot of honor, you give me lot of dishonor, you give me Vaikuntha vas, or you give me Naraka nivas, Krishna, I have no problem. Just keep me close to your lotus feet. Don't forget me, that's all. We find this prayerful mood throughout. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, why are the demigods offering prayers to the womb of Devaki before Krishna's adventing? Why are Manigriva and Nalakuvera offering prayers to Krishna after their liberation? Why is Dhruva Maharaj offering prayers? Why is Prahlad Maharaj offering prayers? Why is Vritrasur offering his Chatushloki? Why is Kunti Devi offering her prayers? Why is Bhishma offering prayers? And why is Brahmā offering prayers? Sometimes when we see the chapter on prayers, we skip. Prayers chapter, are ye wohi wohi prayer hai. Skip. But nahi hai. Same nahi hai. Sab alag hai. The devotee, the bhakta, is connecting with Krishna through the prayers. And we have to understand that when we have to write a letter to someone, what are the three things important? किसी को पत्र लिखना हो तो तीन चीज क्या मुख्य है उसमें क्या क्या चाहिए हमें एड्रेस कहां भेजना है पहले पता हुम टू सेंड इट टू डेस्टिनेशन एड्रेस सेकंड सब्सटेंस क्या भेजना है पत्र भेजना है क्या संदेश भेजना है कंटेंट थर्ड एनवलप टू पुट इट एंड सेंड So similarly, when we have to send anything to Krishna, we need three things. First, right address, Krishna. Interestingly, some people put the wrong address. They send it to some Baba or some guru of this world who himself is in the jaws of the crocodile. If you pray to someone who is in the jaws of the crocodile himself, he cannot save us. He cannot save us. Therefore, in the prayers of Gajendra, we find Gajendra did not call out to any demigod. Because demigods are peaceful. They have long duration. Dviparardha Dishna. Brahmā Bibheti. Markandeya Muni is telling the Naranarayan Rishi in 8th chapter of 12th canto that even Brahmā, who lives for 311 trillion, 40 billion years, has to come down. So Gajendra is not calling out to the demigods, and interestingly, he is not even calling out to Krishna directly. No mention of Hari, Adhokshaja, Madhava, Govinda. He says, Namo Atma Pradipaya. I bow down to He who illuminates from within in all bodies. That is only one personality, Krishna. I bow down to He who is the ultimate shelter for everyone. That is Krishna. I bow down to He who is present everywhere. That is Krishna. I bow down to He who gives ultimate bliss to everyone. That is Krishna, not even the demigods. So indirectly, Gajendra is calling out to Krishna, the Supreme Lord, Vishnu. And he makes this point also, very interestingly. Madrik prapanna pashupasha vimokshanaya muktaya bhuri karunaya namolayaya. Whom am I calling, O Lord? For my mukti, for my liberation, Gajendra is saying, I am calling out to muktaya. I am calling out to a person who is free from that crocodile. The demigods are also inside crocodile because they are in the material creation. But Krishna, who is beyond time and space, he is the one who is outside the jaws of the crocodile. So muktaya, I call to Krishna who is outside of problems. He is mukta. And bhuri karunaya, he is ready to help. He is filled with mercy. And Krishna showers mercy in unlimited, inconceivable manner. Sometimes we think, Bhagavan ne ye kyu kiya? Agar Bhagavan karuna ki murti hai, to ye kyu kiya? If Krishna is the embodiment of mercy, to aisa hona chahiye tha. Aise kyu kiya? That it should be like this. But the interesting thing is, can we understand Krishna's mercy? Our intellect is only so much and Krishna's mercy is unending. How can the finite hold the infinite? Krishna's mercy is inconceivable. He showers mercy to Bali by taking away everything. He showers mercy on Sudama by giving everything. So if we say Krishna's mercy is in giving, then Bali is opposite. If we say Krishna's mercy is in taking, then Sudama is opposite. He gives mercy to Hiranyakashipu as death. But he gives mercy to Prahlad as protection. So Krishna's mercy is inconceivable. Bhuri karunaya. And Krishna is ever ready. Namo alaya. He's saying, I am bowing down to that personality who acts immediately. Krishna doesn't say, okay, you chant, and after about 25, 35 lifetimes, I'll help you. Immediate. If the calling out is desperate and helpless, ye yatham mam prapadhyante tam stataiva bhajamyam. Why will Krishna not help? If Krishna helped Draupadi when she called out through the holy name, if Krishna helped Gajendra when he called out through the holy name, when Krishna helped Dhruva when he called out through the holy name, when Krishna helped Prahlad when he called out through the holy name, when Krishna is helping so many devotees when they surrender and really feel that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Shri Krishna, without you I have nobody, please help me. And when they are calling out to thought, word and deed, why will Krishna not help? So the right address is important. Calling out to Krishna, Shri Hari. The demigods thought, he didn't call us, we will not go. Krishna thought, he didn't take my name, or Vishnu thought, he didn't take my name, but from his description, he's actually referring to me, I should go. Bhuri karunaya. And as Hariparshat Prabhu was explaining yesterday, Krishna was, or the Supreme Lord was in so much anxiety and he was rushing to help Gajendra that he didn't even have time to put asan on top of Garuda. Garuda ko bole, chalo, asan lagane ke liye samay nahi hai. The Lord's charioteer, Daruka, is asking, I'll take you. He says, no, I will run and reach. Don't worry. He is not even waiting for the conch shell to blow. The Lord doesn't do anything without conch shell. They're saying, arey, conch shell will blow, then you'll go. No, you blow later, I'm leaving. And that was the time when the Lord was flying faster than Garuda. Garuda was thinking, till then, I am the one who takes the Lord. But Krishna was crushing his pride also. He was flying faster than Garuda with so much eagerness. I have to save my devotee. Why? Because my devotee is calling out to me. So the right address is important. The content is important. Our feeling, our bhava, our prayerful mood is important. And what is the envelope? The envelope of prayers, the envelope of the holy name. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So therefore, simply chanting and simply offering prayers is very good. But it is incomplete if the mood is not there. Just like if I put the right address and I send the envelope, but there is no content inside, what is the use? Krishna is not Namagrahi. Krishna is not Stotra or Stuti or Stava Grahi. He is Bhava Grahi. Our stotras, our stutis, these prayers, these prarthana, the holy name when we chant, it is the envelope which carries. But our mood is the content. That is what Krishna is tasting. So when we are making garlands for Krishna, we are offering flowers like Gajendra is offering. But is the mood the same? When we are making garlands and offering flowers to Krishna, it is the same as Gajendra is offering. But why is it that when we offer, we are not seeing Krishna coming and wearing it in person? But we find for Gajendra, he is offering the lotus and the Supreme Lord is coming and accepting. Why? What is the difference? If the Lord can come and take it from the trunk of an animal, why can't he take it from the hands of a human, a devotee who has tilak and kanthi? Because we lack that mood, that crying spirit that Gajendra had. There is nobody who has cried for Krishna and has not got him. Whoever cried for help got Krishna. And the time when we really need help and we call out to Krishna in the darkest regions of our time, of our life, they are the most auspicious because they invoke Krishna's mercy. One devotee, along with other devotees, they went for book distribution. And while returning, They were coming in a slope and the brake failed. Now imagine if you're coming like 10, 12 devotees in a big jeep or a truck or whatever you call it, and the brakes fail and you know what's coming up. What is your mood at that time? Only one thing you remember. Namaste Narasimhaya. And how is that Namaste Narasimhaya? Is it like, you know, kabhi kabhi phone dekh liya? Ya baat karte karte Narasimha Arati. Is that how we'll chant when the brakes have failed? We call out to Narasimha Dev with our heart and soul because we realize this is the last Narasimha Arati of our life. Yes or no? And in that mood when we cry out, that invokes the Lord's mercy. Somehow the driver, he could steer the vehicle and it hit a tree. Instead of total damage, the car was destroyed, but all 12 devotees came victorious. They were all saved. So that devotee who sang Narasimha Arati, when he was giving class, he said, dear devotees, I have sung Narasimha Arati so many times in my life, but that Narasimha Arati was the best. In fact, he was telling me, Prabhu, I really wish that incident happens again and again. I said, Are, why are you saying this? It is not auspicious. He said, no, Prabhu, in my life, that is the most auspicious event. Because due to that fear, I cried out for the protection of Narasimha Dev like never before and never after. I wish every day this happens to me so that I can cry to the Lord. And then he smiled and he said, and I wish every day he saves me also. So in this way we find those times in our life when sorrow comes in, when there is pain, when there is suffering, instead of crying and taking sympathy from people around who don't solve our problems, if we cry out to Sri Sri Radha Rasbihari, if we cry out to Gauranitai, if we fall at the feet of Sri Ram, why will we not be protected? Abhayam sarvada tasmai dadami etad vratam mama. Sri Ram, he said, sakrid eva prapannoyam. He who comes to me, surrenders to me, cries out to me and says, I am yours, my Lord. To that person, abhayam sarvada tasmai dadami etad vratam mama. I fill him with so much protection that he will forget what fear is. So Gajendra and Draupadi called out. That was the envelope. They called out to the right address, Shri Hari. But what was the content? The content was their bhav, their helpless mood. So when we read Srimad Bhagavatam, that is the envelope. When we make garlands, it is our envelope. When we perform arati, it is our envelope. When we chant Harinam and do kirtan, that is our envelope. But in all these activities, the content is our helpless mood. If we think every day, every situation, I am Gajendra, I am bleeding, but still I am thinking I am okay. The crocodile is biting me, chewing me, sinking with sharp teeth and jaws inside my body. But alas, I have no taste for Krishna. I have no attachment to Krishna. Krishna, please save me. And the Supreme Lord is saying, Ami bina bandhuar ke achhe tumar. Apart from me, whom do you have anyway? But we are thinking, Krishna, you can wait. Prabhu, we should become a devotee. Oh, I can become devotee later. First, business. Prabhu, you should read Bhagavad Gita. I can read Bhagavad Gita later. First, wealth. Because our mindset is, Krishna has been waiting for so many lifetimes. He will wait. He knows to wait. But my wealth, my business cannot wait. My exams cannot wait. When we make Krishna our priority, when we do things for Krishna, other things secondary. Srila Prabhupada would say about his father, Srila Gaur Mohande, who was a cloth merchant. He said, my father's main business was puja. And side business was cloth. So similarly in our life, when our main priority, our main business is crying out for the mercy of Krishna, that's when Krishna descends. Ye yatham mam prapadyante. We all have to work. Even Mother Yashoda had to sweat. Swinnam vaktram. She had to sweat, run, try, cry. Then Damodar was bound. Otherwise impossible. So what to speak of us? So this is the second point. First point, realizing we are all Gajendras. Second point, understanding that the crocodile will open its mouth and we'll get protection only when we put the right address in the right envelope with the right mood. And the third point and the last point for this discussion is the unlimited, inconceivable mercy of Krishna. Look at the fortune of Gajendra. Gajendra had not performed any bhakti in that life. In his previous life, he was King Indradyumna, who was cursed by Agastya Rishi. King Indradyumna, due to some act, indirectly offended Agastya Muni. And Agastya Muni, he said, your activities are dull. And therefore, in your next life, you will become an elephant. King Indradyumna is so exalted. Agastya Muni cursed. Similarly for the crocodile. Crocodile was Gandharva Huhu in his previous life. Interesting name, Huhu. And he was cursed by a sage called Devala. He was a rishi. They both went to the river, holy river. And when Devala Rishi was performing Gayatri, this Gandharva, out of fun, he pulled the leg of Devala Rishi. And Devala Rishi said, you are such a rascal. I am performing Gayatri and you are troubling me in the water. Therefore, I curse you. You will trouble everyone being in the water. May you be a crocodile. So Indradyumna Maharaj became crocodile. Indradyumna Maharaj became Gajendra. Huhu became crocodile. But what is striking and what touched me when I was reading this section is the fact that Gajendra forgot Krishna in his life, but Krishna never forgot him. Krishna never forgets anyone. And what to speak of those who perform bhakti once? Neha bikrama nashosti pratyavayo na vidyate swalpam apyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bhayat. The Gita explains somebody who performs simple, sincere, serious, strict, honest, heartfelt, desperate, helpless service to Krishna. Krishna never forgets him. 100 lifetimes also ahead. Vatadi yadi doshena mad bhakta mamcha nacha smaret aham smarami mad bhakto nayami paramam gatim. In the Puranas it is said, what happens to a devotee who performs bhakti all his life, but at the time of death, because of the pain of his body, he is not able to remember Krishna? Kabhi kabhi ye ho sakta hai, hai na? We can think that aajivan bhakti karke, all my life I'm performing bhakti, mrityu ke kaal mein agar bhagwan ka smaran na ho to, agar hum bhagwan ko bhool gaye to, what happens if all my life I perform bhakti and I still forget Krishna at the time of death? There is so much pain that I'm not able to remember him. Arthi slok says, aham smarami mag bhakto. Krishna is saying, even if my devotee forgets me, no problem. I will come. I remember my devotee. I remember each and every devotee. So why should we fear whether we remember Krishna at the time of death or no? It's beyond our control. But now when the body is sane, it is healthy. This moment, in this human form of life, when our senses are working, why not call out to Krishna? Aham smarami, Krishna says. And interestingly, Krishna doesn't just record and remember the devotee. At the right time when Gajendra was in pain, Krishna as Paramatma invoked the remembrance of the Lord from within. The Lord could have just said, okay, I remember Gajendra, theek hai. But he didn't just say that. He records, remembers, and helps the devotee recollect. Gajendra, out of nowhere, all his life never attended Mangal Arati, never chanted Japa, never had any Sadhu Sangha, but in his previous life, he performed bhakti, because of which Krishna helped him when he needed help. Out of nowhere, Gajendra is speaking Sanskrit prayers. Sanskrit mein stuti kar rahe hain Bhagwan ki. Asambhav. How can an elephant do this? Have you ever seen an animal talk? And that to speak in Sanskrit and that to glorify the Lord? And those prayers which are chanted till today, Gajendra Moksha is celebrated even today. How is it possible? Because of Krishna. Because of the Supreme Lord's mercy, he remembered Gajendra. He recorded Gajendra's activity. He remembered him, helped him recollect. Matta smriti jnanam apohanam cha. Krishna says, from me comes remembrance, knowledge and forgetfulness. And most importantly, he doesn't stop there. These are the four R's that the Lord deals with. All our activities, he records, he remembers, helps us recollect, and most importantly, when we call out to him, he rescues also. We pray to him, he remembers us. He induces remembrance from within. And when we chant, he comes and helps also. Who does this? Only Hari does. Only Krishna does. What mercy. But one thing that touched me the most in this pastime was one place I was reading. Could be a commentary or a realization of a great Vaishnav. He says, the Supreme Lord came running. Ashu, in this verse we find, immediately. He say, those pandits or those kavis who can compose poetry immediately are called Ashu Kavi or Asu Kavi. Because they can compose immediately. Krishna is bhuri karunaya. He has so much mercy and he comes Ashu immediately. What touched me the most when I was reading is the fact that he came, he pulled Gajendra and the crocodile out. With his chakra, he killed the crocodile and relieved Gajendra. But the fascinating thing is, he liberated the crocodile first. Gajendra is calling out to the Lord. The Lord could have given liberation to Gajendra first. But the chakra hits the crocodile and the crocodile first gets liberated. One great Vaishnav, he writes, the crocodile had indirectly heard the importance of Sadhu Sangha, had heard the importance of associating with a great devotee. And the crocodile was thinking, I can never go out and take Sadhu Sangha, because crocodile is the species of water. An elephant is the species of land, and therefore we find the struggle of Gajendra and the crocodile. It's like if there is one cricket team playing another in home ground, then there is home ground advantage. So here crocodile is in its home ground and Gajendra is out of home ground. So therefore crocodile got stronger and stronger and Gajendra got weaker and weaker. So crocodile could never come out. So he was thinking, sadhus are outside, I am inside the water, how can I get sadhu sangha? But when Gajendra entered, crocodile realized, arey, he is not just king of elephants, he is even king of Vaishnavas. He himself is coming inside. I have to associate with him. And how do you associate with a Vaishnav? You fall at his feet and you never let him go. Bhakta pada dhuliyara bhakta pada jal bhakta bhukta avashesho tini mahabal. The Chaitanya Charitamrita says you associate with a Vaishnav by taking the dust from the lotus feet of Vaishnav, by drinking the charanamrita of the Vaishnav and partaking in the remnants of the Vaishnav. This is the external meaning. The internal meaning is taking the dust from the feet of Vaishnav means taking their instructions. Vani, siksha. Taking the charanamrita of a Vaishnav means drinking harikatha through the ears from their lips. Pibata, bhagavata rasamalayam. And taking the remnants of their prasad means taking the attachment that they have for Krishna little into our heart. So crocodile thought, I can't take his remnants. He, by touching the water, the whole water is charanamrita. I can drink any time. But padadhuli I can get only now. So he caught Gajendra's feet to get that padadhuli. And Krishna, the Supreme Lord, he's saying, aham bhakta paradhino yah svatantra ivodvija sadhu bir ghrasta hridayam bhaktair bhakta janapriya. That, oh dear devotee, I am conquered by my devotees, but I am more conquered by the devotees of my devotees. So Gajendra is offering stuti. He is my devotee. But this crocodile, directly, indirectly, is holding the feet of this great Vaishnav. Oh, I have to liberate him first. Therefore, we find in the Ramayana, Lakshman is great. But Valmiki, he writes, greater than Lakshman is Shatrughna. Because Lakshman was the servant of Sri Ram. But Shatrughna was the servant of Bharat, who was the devotee of Ram. So, Lakshman is the devotee of the Lord, while Shatrughna is the devotee of the Lord. Dasa Dasa Anu Das. And therefore, Shatrughna is the silent hero. So the Lord liberated crocodile. Now the point could be, well, the mood of the crocodile was not favorable. But the Lord doesn't care about it. Putana appeared for what? To kill the Lord. But the Lord liberated Putana. His Holiness Radha Govinda Maharaj, in one katha, he said very beautifully. He said, Hamare jagat mein, jab log aake hame amrit pilate hain, to hum unhe vish de dete hain. इस जगत में लोग जब आके हमें अमृत की बूंदे दे देते हैं तो हम उनको विष देकर मार देते हैं. पर भगवान की करुणा को देखो, जिसको विष पिलाने आई उस पूतना को भगवान ने अमर कर दिया. सो दिस इज द मर्सी ऑफ द लॉर्ड. अहो बकीयम स्तन कालकूटम. द लॉर्ड डजंट सी फेवरेबल अनफेवरेबल. यू अप्रोच हिम, यू गेट प्यूरिफाइड. इट्स लाइक होल्डिंग द इलेक्ट्रिक वायर, लाइव वायर, ओपन वायर. Whether you're a child, whether you're an old man, whether you're male, female, whether you know, you don't know, you hold, you're electrocuted. Similarly, as soon as you hold the electric wire of the Lord's mercy, all the sins are destroyed. And the last part of the discussion is that crocodile was liberated because of this, but why was Gajendra bleeding? Crocodile is causing harm to a Vaishnav. Yes? The crocodile is holding the feet of Gajendra and this is paining for the devotee. So the Acharya writes that Gajendra is such a Mahanubhav, great Vaishnav, that to give liberation to crocodile, he is ready to bleed. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, to make one devotee, we have to give gallons and gallons and liters of sweat and blood. So Gajendra is ready to bleed to give liberation to the crocodile. He's thinking, I can be liberated anytime, but this crocodile, it's now or never. He's holding, no problem. It's paining for me, no problem. Krishna save him. So in this way, our spiritual superiors, our siksha gurus, our diksha guru, our patpradarshak guru, and senior ocean of Vaishnavas, they're all like Gajendras. And sometimes we, like the crocodile, are biting and disturbing them, but they are ready to bleed to uplift us. So in this mood, let us be Gajendra and crocodile both. In what way? Let us be Gajendra in the spirit of helpless calling out for the mercy of the Lord. And let us be the crocodile in the spirit that let us never leave the lotus feet of pure Vaishnavas away in our life. Let us always hold it through mouth, through hand, and in our heart. Hare Krishna. If there are any questions or comments, yes, Prabhu, at the back. Can we pass the mic, please?
Very nicely you have said about Gajendra and Draupadi. I would like to know who is devotee? Exactly who is the devotee?
Devotee is he who devotes his life for Krishna. Srila Viṣṇu Chakravarti Thakur, in one commentary to the Srimad Bhagavatam, he says, on the level of devoting our life to Krishna, there are different stages. Devoting time for Krishna is the beginning. Then devoting our ears for Krishna is the second. Then devoting our tongue, throat by chanting Harinam and honoring Prasadam is the third stage. Then devoting our mind in thinking of Krishna is the fourth stage. The fifth stage is devoting our heart in Krishna's service. And the sixth and the final stage is devoting thought, word and deed completely, karmana, manasa, vacha, in the service of Krishna. So the word devotee or bhakta is a very big title. Bhakta is he who performs bhakti. Devotee is he who devotes completely in the service of Krishna. So sometimes we think that devotee is he who is in ISKCON for 30 years. I am senior devotee. But one devotee, very beautifully he says, we don't become senior by seeing years in bhakti. I have seen 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. But we become senior by seeing through our ears. Not seeing years, but seeing Krishna Katha through our ear. So he who devotes his time in the service of Hari, Guru and Vaishnava, in serving Tulsi, without kapat, saralta hi Vaishnavta. Let us not be in ISKCON because we have some hidden agenda. Let us not be associated with a temple because we want something out of it. I want this, I can get this in ISKCON, therefore I am doing this. I want name, fame, recognition. I could not enter Bollywood, therefore let me become a Kirtaniya. Let us not have this spirit. This hidden agenda, or in any service for that matter, Krishna never accepts. And in the true sense, we are not devotees. People may give so many garlands, and people may give so much stuti and respect. But in heart, because we have kapat, we are not serving Krishna, we are not devoted to Krishna, we are devoted to name fame. We are devoted to money. If I am in this position, paisa milta hai. Isliye paisa chahiye, isliye main ye seva kar raha hu. Bhagwan ki santushti ke liye nahi kar raha hu. So how are we a devotee? Then I am devoted to money. I am devoted to position. I am devoted to other things. But Krishna Bhakta is Nishkam. Bhukti Mukti what is that? Krishna Bhakta Nishkam Athayeva Shanta Bhukti Mukti Siddhi Kami Sakali Ashanta. So if we have hidden agenda, we will be miserable. Therefore, we find devotees being in Krishna consciousness and after so many years leaving also. And they say, nahi Prabhu, politics hai, nahi Prabhu, management aisa hai, nahi Prabhu, inhone aise kaha. Kisi ne bhi kuch nahi kaha. The problem is not there. The problem is here. Hum seva badalte hain, mandir badalte hain, congregation badalte hain. Kyon? Ye mandir mein problem hai, wo congregation mein problem hai, ye seva mein politics hai. Kahin bhi kuch bhi nahi hai. Hamare andar kapat hai. Hum Bhagwan ke santushti ke liye nahi kar rahe hain seva. Hamare dhan, jan, yash, puja, lab, pratishtha, is uddesh se kar rahe hain hum seva. Therefore, we are devoted to that. Those who in the true sense are ready to serve Krishna even if everything is given or if everything is taken away. Vaikunta vasam athava narakeni vasam. He is devotee. So if we have that sincerity, which comes by the mercy of Hari Guru and Vaishnava, or at least we can pray and beg to Krishna. Krishna, I don't have it, but I want it. I really want to devote this human form of life in your seva. I don't want to be a complaining devotee. I don't want to be a blaming devotee. I don't want to be a criticizing devotee. Are Prabhu, kya hua? Are poochho mat Prabhu, yahan ye hua. Are Mataji, kya hua? Are wo Mataji ne ye kaha. Kisi ne bhi kuch nahi kaha. There is no problem anywhere. That dukhalem is there because of us. We are not serving Krishna, and even if we are serving Krishna, we are not with the right spirit. So he who surrendered to Krishna with saralta, surrendered to Guru and sincerely wants Krishna's mercy in his heart, that person, even if he gives 1 minute in Krishna's service, that is more valuable than giving all our life in duplicity. Hare Krishna. Yes. Yeah, mic de sakte hain? After that we'll come here.
Sure.
All right. Sure. We'll take only one question. Others we can take offline after the class. So we'll give it to Prabhu.
Krishna.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Jab hi bata rahe the ki main hai bhav. Agar Bhagwan ka naam lete hain to bhav se. तो हमेशा एक एक मूड नहीं रहता कि मैं भाव से भगवान का नाम लूँ. नॉर्मल चैंटिंग करते हैं सुला रहा हूँ तो भाव नहीं रहता. तो भाव कैसे करें हम?
भाव कैसे उत्पन्न किया हाँ. जाए?
वो भाव से कैसे चैंटिंग करें? जैसे अभी गजेंद्र है वो संकट में था इसीलिए वो अपना भाव प्रकट कर रहा था. तो हम लोग हमेशा भाव नहीं रहते कि भगवान का हरे कृष्ण बोलो.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. तो प्रश्न ये है कि भगवान की भक्ति या भगवान को नाम पुकार ये भाव से करना चाहिए. तो ये भाव को कैसे लाया जाए? सो आई विल आंसर इन इंग्लिश सो दैट प्रभु कैन टेक इट इन हिंदी. सो हाउ टू गेट दैट मूड ऑफ हेल्पलेसनेस, आई विल टेल यू अ वेरी फनी स्टोरी. वन ब्रह्मचारी इन गोपीनाथ टेम्पल, व्हेन ऑफ कोर्स नॉट नाउ बट मेनी इयर्स अगो इन द नाइन आई थिंक इधर 90s और अर्ली 2000s, ही वुड चैंट इन अ रूम अंडर अ फैन. And different devotees would have different ways of focusing. Some would keep picture of Radha Gopinath or Radha Rasbihari. Some would keep the Hare Krishna Mahamantra written, syllables. Some would have some prayer. But this devotee had a chit. He would sit under a fan and the chit would read, "Dear devotee, call out to Krishna desperately because the screw of the fan above is loose." The fan can fall anytime. So he would look, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. But this is a funny story. But the real answer to this, Bhaktistu Bhagavad Bhakta Sangena Parijayate. How do we get wealth? From somebody who has it. Similarly, how do we get bhav or attachment to Krishna? By being with somebody who has it. If we associate with devotees or people who are serial fault finders, in no time we are doing Vaishnava or Bhakta Sangha, but we are getting fault finding. But if we associate with devotees who really want Krishna in their life, who are really sincere, ekmatra lakshya hai jeevan mein ki bhagavat prapti. Bhautik star pe kuch mile na mile, bhagwan de na de, farak nahi padta. Bhagwan lenge bhi aur denge bhi. Par bhagwan ek cheez sthit rakhna mere jeevan mein, aapke prati rati utpan karna, aapke prati aasakti utpan karna. Krishna, please get this in my life. This comes by associating with devotees who have it. So by sitting close to devotees who have taste in Harinam, by hearing Hari Katha from people who have taste in Bhagavatam, by people who really believe in Vaishnava Seva, we get that quality. Nothing happens overnight. But by focused endeavor, day after day, month after month, year after year, slowly and gradually we find, in no time, we had no attachment, and now we are having some attachment. So Vaishnav Sangha, that to Rupa Goswami in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, he says, Sadhu Sangha Swatovare. Swatovare means associating with people who are senior to us. By sitting with them, those who really have taste in Harinam, Bhagavatam, Vaishnav Seva, or Ninda Na Karna. Aise bhakton ka sang jab karte hain, to unke hriday se bhav hamare hriday mein jagrit ho jata. This is one thing. Last but not the least, I want to end this discussion with one verse by Srila Rupa Goswami. This is one, and this is also in continuation to your question. This is one verse that I chant regularly because this is prayer to Krishna. Krishna, give me that bhav towards your holy name. Two things, bhakt can give us and Krishna can give us. So we get it from the devotee by associating with the devotee, and we get it from Krishna by asking him. So let's chant this verse.
Yes.
Aghadamana Yashoda Nandanandana Suno Kamala Nayana Gopi Chandra Vrindavanendra Pranata Karuna Krishna Ityaneka Swarupe Twai Mamarati Uchair Vardhatam Namadheya Twai Mamarati Uchai Vardhatam Namadheya. O Krishna's holy name, please bless me that my attachment towards you increases. That's the prayer. But what are the different names of Krishna? Aghadamana. Aghadamana means he who destroys sin. Yashoda Nandana, son of Yashoda. Nanda Suno, O the son of Nanda Maharaj. Kamala Nayana, lotus eyed one. Gopi Chandra, the moon of the Braja Gopis. Vrindavanendra, the lord of Vrindavan. Pranata Karuna, he who shows mercy on those who bow down to him. Krishna, the all-attractive one. Iti aneka swarupe. O Lord, you have so many such names. Twai mama rati uchai vardatam namadheya. O these names of Krishna, please bless me. Let me have some taste for you. Agadamana Yashoda, Nandano, Nandasuno, Kamala Nayana Gopi, Chandra Vrindavanendra, Pranata Karuna Krishna, Ityaneka Swarupe, Twai Mama Rati Uchai Vardhatam Namadhi. Hare Krishna.